And much credit for Bangladesh's incredible rise goes to Sheikh Hasina Wajid, the daughter of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and the longest serving Prime Minister of Bangladesh. She's currently serving her fourth term. And she is one of the only two women leaders, women heads of state in Asia. The other one is Tsai Ing-wen of Taiwan. Her soft manner and steely determination have often been discussed in the press, but the world knows little about her political journey and her contribution to the growth of her country. In our next report, we get you the story of Sheikh Hasina. Sheikh Hasina's journey has been a fascinating one. She has seen military rule. She has been in detention. She has lived in exile. And she has survived assassination attempts. Her political career began in the late 1960s, when she served as her father's political messenger during his numerous stints in jail. In 1975, she was in West Germany when her father, mother, and three brothers were assassinated. Left with no one but her sister, Sheikh Hasina spent the next 6 years of her life in exile. In India, she lived at Ring Road in New Delhi's Lajpat Nagar area, and then near Pandara Park till 1981. It was during this self-exile that Sheikh Hasina was elected the president of the Awami League. On her return to Dhaka in 1981, she became a prominent and outspoken advocate for democracy. In the years that followed, she fought the military generals of Bangladesh and initiated several steps to secure basic human rights for her countrymen. But it wasn't till 1996 when Sheikh Hasina became the Prime Minister of Bangladesh. In her first stint, she achieved laudable successes in many fields, the most significant being the 30-year Ganges Water Sharing Treaty with India, the peace accord on the Chittagong Hill Tracts, the construction of the Bangabandhu Bridge, allowances for distressed women, widows, and the disabled, and the Asharyan project aimed at eradicating homelessness. In 2009, she was re-elected. This time, she oversaw the resolution of maritime disputes with Myanmar and India. Bangladesh's GDP growth surged to 6%. An estimated 50 million Bangladeshis were elevated to the middle income group. And there was a slump in poverty levels from 38% in 2006 to 24% in 2013. In 2014, she secured the top office for the third time. The per capita income of Bangladesh rose to $1,602. The poverty rate slumped further to 22.4%, while forex reserves rose to $32 billion. In 2017, Bangladesh's GDP stood at $250 billion. And in 2019, the annual GDP growth was at 8.15%. Sheikh Hasina has been bestowed with several honors too. The Mother Teresa Award in 1998, the Indira Gandhi Peace Award in 2009, the UNESCO Peace Tree Award in 2014. She featured on the 59th place in the 2015 Forbes list of the 100 most powerful women. And in 2018, the Time 100 praised her for accepting Rohingya refugees. Sheikh Hasina is also known for her wit and gentle diplomacy. But like any other leader, she's not been able to escape some controversies. Critics say that under her tenure, Bangladesh has witnessed democratic backsliding, an accusation which gets complex the deeper one tries to dig. Bureau Report, We On, World is One.
We On is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.